We're here to purify you, but it'll still hurt.
Purification complete!
Victory shall be mine!
Let us relish this victory and sally forth.
What's that?
Oh, aren't you just the cutest thing?
It's just a squirrel.
No, don't you see? The fluffiness of the tail. It must be the Falquin squirrel. A rare sight indeed.
Calm down.
But look, it's so fluffy, poofy, adora-poofy! Don't tell me you're not moved by its precious little face!
I'm not. Unlike you, I don't feel a need to ooh and coo over cute things to make others think I'm cute as well.
What? No, that's not at all—
Shh! You'll frighten poor Poofy away.
You're right. My apologies.
If you're truly sorry, do the squirrel carena for me. The fluffy version.
There's a squirrel carena? There's a fluffy version?
Poor Alicia. She's so easy to toy with.
Should we leave them like this?
Understood, Miss Edna. Please teach me the squirrel carena. I wish to master this fluffy version.
Are you sure? My training is very strict.
I'm up for the challenge.
I think it's all right. They look like they're having fun.
True enough.
Let's do this!
What incredible skill! I finished preparing the bottles.
Looks like we win! Counting on you, Lila! Purification complete!
Surely this is fate! Awake, Rudder!
Prepared is to be protected. Is this because of the epidemic? I take it that you're not good around dogs.
Not particularly.
Miklio's just worried about claws and effect.
What?
I want to become stronger as a seraph.
You have more than enough talent for it. Don't push yourself too hard.
A Hellion right here in town?
Of course. Look how full of malevolence this place is.
And that just now was a dog Hellion, wasn't it?
Right. That was a hellhound. The pathogen itself has assumed Hellion form.
The plague itself?
Let's hurry to the sanctuary and deliver the medicine. Is that a monolith?
Sure is a lot of gold lying around out there.
Lady Alicia, you made it safely!
I've brought medicine. What's happening?
We can do naught to stop the infection. The disease has spread to our ranks. We cannot even exterminate the wild dogs.
At this rate, the entire kingdom may very well succumb to its ravages.
By the stars!
First, please distribute the medicine.
Right away!
Things will be okay. They've got resources now.
Yes.
And we can help dispatch the hellhounds.
And yet, I suspect that they are not the true source of this epidemic.
A stronger Hellion, born of powerful malevolence.
Thank you.
another dragon!
No, it's just a Hellion. You can tell because the humans don't see it.
It's landing over there!
Don't tell me you're gonna fight it. It looks like a dragon to me.
We don't know that for sure. You can tell me if it gets too dangerous.
Wonderful. And I wind up with all the responsibility as usual.
That Hellion is called a drake. It's a younger form of dragon.
It looks like the city's malevolence is energizing it somehow.
Then we have to kill it while we still have time.
Wait!
Don't, Alicia!
Hold on!
Look out!
Oh, crap!
That was close. Sorry, we didn't mean to startle you.
Huh.
Again?
Well, we gotta do something. Edna, you said that the malevolence in the city is energizing that thing, right?
Probably.
Then we should focus on purifying the malevolence.
Indeed. I expect that would naturally weaken the drake.
Although it sounds like a huge hassle.
Well, you gotta break a few eggs to make an omelet.
The plan sounds good enough to me, though your choice of metaphor less so.
Even if we do manage to weaken it, we can't fight it if we can't bring it down.
We'll find a way to accomplish that, too. With everyone's help.
Hassle times two.
Slow and steady wins the race, Edna.
Oh, yes. I prefer that metaphor to the one where we're eggs that go splat.
Time to begin operation slow and steady. Shall I help you carry those?
No, I'm just fine.
A history of Monmouth culture and the works of Sir Geoffrey!
Wow, it's the first time I'm seeing them.
These are valuable books. I'm hiding them away so they don't get lost or destroyed in the war.
Oh, then all the more reason I should be help-
It's fine. It's a classified location. Don't tell anyone about this. It's to protect the books.
Something's up.
You think so?
Don't you? She was all excuses and we didn't even say anything.
I certainly never heard of any such secret library.
I understand you wanting to trust her, but something's wrong.
Kinda funny to bury books in a graveyard.
I'm similarly concerned. Let's hide and observe.
All right.
Don't kid yourself, Agatha. That's worth 1,000 at best. Who's there?
You're...
So you lied to us about protecting the books?
It was always just my daughter and I barely getting by. I couldn't even give her one happy memory before she died. Haven't I suffered enough? Can I not have something good for once in my life?
Malevolence!
We're taking these back. I'll be turning you into the guards for misappropriation and theft.
I always knew. Someday this was bound to happen.
The malevolence is fading.
I don't need this anymore. Do you think you can return it to Nafe for me?
Catching her quelled the malevolence?
That's probably what she wanted deep down, to be brought to justice.
Well, I guess that proves that she really did love books after all.
Earth dwellers are such a chore.
I can sense the ancient tongue. We're near one. I just saw a monolith written in ancient tongue. Going in?
So, are you scared of ghosts too?
Would you like me to hold your hand?
It's not like that. You understand, don't you, Saray? I'm sensing a huge domain. There's definitely a strong Hellion here.
It could be hiding anywhere in the museum. We better canvass the entire area. See what I did there? Canvas is a fabric used as a painting surface and...
Please stop.
Oh wow, I just got it.
See, it was just enough explaining.
It wants us to come in.
Looks like it.
I don't think we've checked that monolith out yet. Is that a monolith?
Such important cultural artifacts.
Very well.
This is awful. We can't forget this.
Is that
really a scorpion? It's so large.
But that makes it easier to hit, right?
Not bad, not bad.
We won. As usual.
Also Hellions. On the ruins?
This one could be much stronger.
You've really seen Hellions like this in that ruin?
Swing your sword around and win.
What about swinging an umbrella around?
What sinister writings? It looks like they were scrawled in blood.
Enemy. Let's prepare for our next battle.
Let's go.
I guess something like this is right.
I can sense the ancient tongue. We're near one.
Is this a statue of the shepherd? What senseless vandalism.
Stand strong!
Hurry! It's over!
Telling. Please pick one.
Okay. Oh, this one's blank.
That means your spirit is pure and clean, like this paper.
Oh, thank you.
She's gullible. Way too gullible.
You ready, Sarai?
Alright,
time you learn some humility.
Remember, this place was in the celestial record.
This statue, it radiates such dignity.
You can tell from his expression that he must have been a great warrior.
A fine man. I would like to see his entire body.
Oh, but wouldn't he be
more or less naked?
That's what makes him attractive, in an aesthetic sense.
Well, it's true that the perfectly toned body of a warrior may be aesthetically pleasing, but...
Alicia! Unladylike!
No, I only meant it as a generalization. I really have no personal interest in that sort of thing.
Not at all, huh?
I mean, not much. Just enough. The normal amount.
Wow, settle down. It's just a statue.
Seriously. Though it's true that King Claudin epitomizes the warrior ideal.
Hold on, this is King Meliodas, right? Not King Claudin.
What? But then it wouldn't match with the style at all.
Yes, because this bust was carved as a speculation on the style of future generations.
I think your interpretation is a bit far-fetched.
Well, I think you're trapped in stereotypical views.
All right. Look, let's drop our preconceptions and start over then. Can we identify the subject? What features stand out?
Wow, settle down. It's just a statue.
Seriously.
Seriously.
another empty victory.
I just saw a monolith written in ancient tongue.
I suppose this Hellion must be the source.
Lucky for you, it isn't a ghost, Nicrio.
I told you it's not like that.
Save it for later. Sorry.
What a fool I was. I should have realized you would be here, Attak.
Oh my goodness! It's pretty Lady Lila. How you been? Oh, you never were a lick of fun.
Is this a friend of yours?
Sort of. It was a long time ago.
My name's Attak. Cheese to please ya.
That's a weird name.
Well, aren't you rude? Don't you know that Attak is a Norman name of the highest pedigree? Means I'm fancy.
It looks sort of like the thing attached to Edna's umbrella.
Let's save talk of Edna's thingy for later, shall we? That one's a particularly long story.
Is it?
Hey, Lila, what's a Norman?
They're a special kind of seraphim. They aren't quite as powerful as a Lord of the Land, but they can still be a help to other Seraphim.
How?
Well, they have the ability to boost another Seraph's power. They're kind of like a maid of sorts.
That's my Lila! You know me like the back of your lily-white hand.
Like a maid? I'm afraid I'm not so sure I get it.
Lila's explanations can be pretty off the cuff.
Silly billies like you could never understand what Lila and I mean to each other.
Not sure I want to understand.
Well, anyways, y'all are Lila's friends and all. Maybe I can treat you to some grub. Nicholas, Sunlight Girl, Jean-Luc's the Loomer. This is a massacre! Who could have done such a thing?
Well...
You did. You turned into a Hellion.
I remember. It was me. I went out of my head, tore my beloved treasures apart, and now they're gone forever!
That made you turn into a Hellion.
I'm sure it's hard for you, but can you tell us about it?
Well, I've always had a real big thing for art, you know? Moved in here a good long while back. Got to whittle my days away, just people watching and gazing at fine art. I wasn't worshipped or nothing, but I weren't lonely neither.
Sounds like a good life.
I was happy. Real happy. Since the countries took to fighting, humans started to get real nasty. That country's bad, they'd say. That country's art is bad. Slash it. Burn it.
So they used art just as fuel for the fires of war.
It's true.
And that ain't the half of it. That's when they started to move the art on the black market.
Oh, so that's where it all went.
They were laughing and clutching their money in their grubby little hands! Hooray for war! Hooray for profits! I got so mad, so dejected, I felt my anger bubbling up, but I was beyond caring. And then... that's when I became a Hellion.
It's not your fault, Attak.
Thanks, son. I appreciate it and all, but I'd like to be alone for a little while.
Never thought that the source of all that malevolence would be the love of art.
Yeah, that was unexpected.
It's the Kingdom of Hylan that caused Attak such pain. If only I had been able to do something.
Malevolence can come from anyone's spirit.
Especially when that spirit holds hate for other people.
And for us Seraphim, the influence we receive from the vessel in particular can be a danger.
So if I started generating malevolence, it'd put everyone in danger?
All of us could become Hellions. Saray, Alicia, the people in their despair cling to those with power that surpasses theirs far more tightly than you may imagine. Do not undervalue your ideals, nor the things that are in your power to accomplish. A shepherd's emotions towards the people he rescues are also his greatest enemy, in a way.
Okay, understood.
Didn't she just tell you not to be so stiff and serious?
Oh, I guess you're right.
But I suppose I don't need to worry about you.
We'll get started so you don't have to.
Just doing what's within our power, right?
So there's no Guardian Seraph here either.
Looks like it.
I don't want to assume that the entire world is like this, but...
I think there are quite a lot of Seraphim who are less than fond of humans.
Can it really be that hard for humans and Seraphim to coexist peacefully again?
Do you really think that could happen? Must be nice living in a fantasy world.
It isn't necessarily just a fantasy.
But look at the reality.
I understand that it may be difficult to achieve, sure. But in reality, there was a time like that in the past.
There are records in the ruins and in the celestial record.
When is this past you're referring to?
Long, long ago. But even now, there are Seraphim like you, Edna.
Huh?
And we figured out that we could bring back the blessing as well.
Yep. I think this is a step towards coexistence with the Seraphim and humans. I'll be counting on you, Edna.
Selfish as ever. That's why I can't stand humans.
Get used to it.
Selfish types everywhere. Jeez.